only one who needs to do it like a super shock. Now I'm, yes, confused, to say the least. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And let's start by just saying happy Liberation Day. If you are Dutch. Because today is the 5th of May. The look that I have filmed, it is online because it is the look that I did in the video yesterday where I explained what May 4th means. If you are Dutch, or at least means to me. Why did I bump the camera? Anyway, so if you want to see how I achieved the look, go watch the video and then you kind of have a little bit of understanding about, well, the 4th and the 5th of May in the Netherlands. So, I'm still feeling good. So I thought, let's kind of, you know, film this video at the same time. Although I really love how the look is. So I wanted to use it in another video, basically. Yeah. Anyway, today is also another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. I think it's number 36. And I have a lot. Actually, the last couple of weeks were kind of slow with new releases, but they really stepped up their game now. This series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is down below. She also created a community playlist where I add my video to as well every week. It's also down below. My sources are there. The products I talk about are there. Some discount codes. You name it. You know, there's a lot of stuff always in my description box. Go check it out. I will also list or link the video I did yesterday. So you can check it out if you want to. I have a little bit of drugstore. I have a lot of indie. And I don't think I have mainstream, but you never know. I don't know exactly what I saved. So let me go to Instagram. Open everything up and yeah. Okay. Number 36 it is. So let me go to the side a little bit. Let me get my coffee because I think I'll need it. And let's just, yeah, see, I have only a tiny bit of drugstore anyway. Okay. So, oh, if you hear anything, any noise from outside, it's because my window is open. Because it is actually, at least where I film, it's nice. It's weird weather today. Very weird, you know. It's sunny. I heard that we also had snow. Well, not where I live, but in the Netherlands, we had snow today. Which hasn't happened in, what was it, 50 years or something? I don't know. Anyway, it's a weird day and it's weird weather. Let's start with something that is also kind of weird. That's this from Revolution because they have collabed with Jamie, I don't know. I don't know who that is actually. But they have some face masks and a face spray. They have a watermelon mask, a coconut mask and a coconut, mango and chia seed mask, then a cocoa and oat mask and a tropical quench face spray. The red one is just like putting jelly, you know, strawberry jam on your face. I don't know if I am, I don't know. I the only thing that was edible that I ever put on my face was honey, you know, a honey mask, but I don't know what to make of this. Each mask is £8. Spray £6. I don't know. I have no idea what to make of this, to be quite honest with you. But I did want to mention it. So, yeah. I don't know if I will get anything, but yeah. Oh, I think it's hailing outside. And a child is crying because they are walking in the hail. Whatever. Anyway, let's go to ColourPop because they introduced some new Super Shock Shadows. Am I the only one who needs to do it like Super Shock? But they are kicking off their fifth birthday with their new Super Shock Extreme formula. It says here, they took their OG Super Shock formula, mixed it with every pearl and pigment in the lab, then injected it with multi-dimensional glitters. The result? Marbled tie-dye extra dimensional magic. Each shade is handmade and hand-pressed, so no two shades are alike. Okay. They are only available in their Party Talk set, and that retails for $30. I think that's fun. They look pretty. I've never tried a Super Shock. I am not particularly interested in trying these. Actually, I don't know why, but because it is, you know, it is a loose shadow and I will probably not grab it. But I did want to mention it anyway, because if you like the Super Shock formula, maybe you will like this one as well. So yeah, I have no idea if they are coming out with more for their fifth birthday, but they are, well, starting strong. Let's go to BH, because BH revealed this. It is already live. It is their Santa Fe eyeshadow palette. I don't know. I'm kind of having a love-hate relationship with this palette. On one hand, if I see it like that, I really like the layout, because it is, I don't know, kind of like artwork, you know? I kind of like that, but then again, I also don't like it. And yeah, the shades are pretty, but it's not really my cup of tea. So I kind of like it and I kind of don't, you know? But yeah, if you do, I will probably go through a lot quickly, because again, I have a lot to talk about. And I think that was it for drugstore. But it could very well be that I have some drugstore further down that I just forgot to pull up to the front. Let's go to this one. This is from, let me see, Love Luxe Beauty. They are launching, or have launched, their Sweet Summertime eyeshadow palette. It launches today or yesterday. 5/4/4. I never know. I always get confused with... We write the day first and then the month. So, but you do it differently. So this will probably be live than yesterday, I think. Anyway, it retails for $35. So yeah. It contains 9 shades. I think it's cute. It looks to me, as I am seeing it on my phone, to be kind of a peachy palette with a pop of shimmery blue. I'm not hating it. Let me see. Ivory, pink, champagne shimmer, coral, turquoise, coral. So yeah, it's a corally palette with a wine red and a blue. That's basically it. I think it's pretty. I don't know if I think it is worth the money, because I've never tried anything from Love Luxe Beauty. I'm not going to get this one either. But I do think it's pretty and I wanted to mention it anyway. Next is Mader Makeup Labs. And I saw, I think, was it Paulina who mentioned the Lady Parts collection that I had missed? Or was it someone else? I don't remember, but someone mentioned that they had a Lady Parts collection, and now that I saw this, they have a Lady Parts collection that they are coming out with. I here have the shade names as well. Let's look at the shades first. The shades look pretty, but they don't really wow me, to be honest with you. The shade names, I'm not particularly loving it either, but I don't know. It's I don't think this collection is for me, not really based on the names, but just on the shade names or on the shade colors, you know, just because I think that I have most of these shades. I've never tried anything from them. So yeah, let me know what you think. Some find it degrading. Yeah, I don't care one way or the other. I actually don't really have an opinion. Is it degrading? I don't think so, but maybe you do. Let me know. Okay, next is Glamlight. We have been getting sneak peeks of their Taco palette for a while now. And here you see a picture of the inside. It is released today. Yes. Let me see. Yeah, it is kind of what I expect, to be honest. I have no idea why there is a dark blue in there, because I don't know a dark blue in a taco, what that would be, but yeah. To be quite honest with you, I think I like the burger palette more, color story wise. But yeah, I'm not hating it, but I like the burger palette more, to be honest. Let me know if you are planning on picking anything up. Then Trendmood showed this, a sneak peek from something that is coming from Juvia's Place, a Nubian 3 Coral Eyeshadow Palette. I thought they were still working on their Warrior 3. But yeah, if they are coming out with a coral palette, I'm actually interested. I don't know anything else. Let me just see real quick if I can find anything more. No, still nothing. I don't know. I have no freaking idea. Maybe Trendmood herself did something. Nope. So yeah, if I know more, I will let you know. I have no idea. Next is, let me see, this is from Lime Crime. Yeah, this is the summer collection from Lime Crime. Difficult to talk today. So you have eyeshadow palette, face palette, lippies and the freckle pen. I think that's basically it. Yeah, I'm not hating the collection. I think it looks pretty. I think it looks summery. And I have never tried anything from Lime Crime. I was not really planning to do so real soon either. But I do think it's fun. Do I have a picture of their eyeshadow palette? Because I'm actually curious to see how that one looks. I'm kind of confused because the way I see the eyeshadow palette has 4 shades. The face palette has 6. But if I look at the picture I have here on my phone, is that the shades that are in the eyeshadow palette look almost the same as the shades that are in the face palette. So now I'm, yes, confused, to say the least. Let's go to Jeffree Star Cosmetics, because this is from his Twitter feed. This month he will be launching his lip glosses. I'm curious to see what colors he comes out with, what they will retail for, and what people think of it, basically. What am I? I don't know what's going on with my camera. I have a setting. I have it on a setting, and I just don't know which one. So, yeah. I also saw this from, am I there yet? Let me see, because, yeah, from XNO or XNO Cosmetics, the Green with Envy palettes. It's a collab. It's a palette created for every creature of the woods. A rich and versatile green toned palette will have you filled with envy. And it is a collab with Sethra Chiffon. In unison with Envious Magazine. I don't know them. But yeah, it's 15 shades, cruelty free. Pre-order ship May the 26th. I'm not hating this palette, to be quite honest with you. It looks pretty. And yeah, you know, if they are going for a foresty theme, I actually get this color scheme. So I'm not hating it. I'm not going to run out and get it, but I'm not hating it. I wanted to mention it to you. So yeah, let's go to the next one. I also saw this from Ofra, because Ofra did a collaboration with Talia Marr. 2 Ofra highlights, one in Covent Garden, which is a scene-stealing champagne rose, and then Soho, which is a sparkling champagne peach. I actually like them both, to be honest with you. Wow, they retail for a whopping $35. Wow, that's so expensive. I have not tried an Ofra highlighter as of yet. I think that if I will, I will get a mini, because, you know, I have some highlighters now. I'm never going to get through a full-sized highlighter. And then for that kind of money, maybe I do not like it. I cannot swatch it in store, so I have to order it online. So then I will probably get a mini first. And then, you know, if I like it, I can always get another one. I do have an Ofra dupe, I think, from Miss Rose, that I think is really, really pretty. So, yeah, well, we'll see. I will probably get one at one point or another, but not just yet. I did want to mention it though. So yeah, next is from, was this Fenty? Yeah, don't fall off your chair. I have never mentioned Fenty before. It's just because it's way out of my price range. And to be honest with you, most products are kind of blah for me. It does not speak to me, but I did like these. These are, let me see, summer 2019 collection, pastel and neon vibes. Eyeliners are in 3 sets in soft neon. You have a hashtag BK, whatever. a pastel pink, a pure white, and a pastel yellow. Then you have two, that's Bayside. It's a papaya, a lime, and a periwinkle. Then you have Baywatch, which is a bold green, a bold berry, and a bold sky blue. So those are the eyeliners. And then you have the Poutsicle, which is a juicy satin lipstick in 7 bold lip colors. You have a hot pink, candy apple, sky blue, teal blue, orchid, blazing orange, and a vivid purple. The lippies will retail for $20 each. And the eyeliner sets for the set include 3, $35 each. I think they will launch May the 10th. So yeah, I'm not going to get anything because it is just too expensive for me. But I did think that this, you know, this is something I could see myself getting. If I had the budget for Fenty, this would be something that I would try. I think this looks really summery. I think this looks fun. I love this. But yeah, again, unfortunately, it is not in my price range. And also, I cannot see this stuff in store. So then it is kind of, you know, it's a little bit a too high a price for me to gamble on. That is basically it. But I do think it is really, really pretty. I love the colors. And yeah, I wanted to mention it anyway. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is Viseart. Yeah, I saw something from Viseart, and this is actually, they are exclusive. This is exclusive with Muse Beauty Pro, which is a website, I think. They are launching 50 of their most requested shades as singles. So, check them out, Muse Beauty, and you know, maybe there are just a few shades that you want from Viseart, or you have, I don't know, hit pan on some of the shades. You can now order some of the singles as well. They will be $12 each, and you can customize them also in their Viseart Slim Pro 12 pen empty case, which is available for $15. So yeah. And next is Michalou Cosmetics. They has released single shadows, so you see pictures here. They are already available. All shadows will be in a clamshell holding. You can remove them and make your own Z palette. They start from £2.99 and up. So yeah, I'm itchy eye. Ah. I've never tried anything from Michalou Cosmetics. I hear, well, kind of mixed reviews, to be honest with you. They are a UK-based indie brand. So I will leave it down below for you guys. Next is Gimme Glow Cosmetics. Oh, Lord, I'm going fast, I know, because I want to not make the video too long. Gimme Glow Cosmetics Juicy Olive Palette is launching the 1st of June, I think. For $30, which I think is quite a hefty price for 6 shades, but that's me personally. I don't know if it is worth it, but my Lord, the colors are gorgeous. This is my kind of color scheme. Love, love. Yes, I love it. I will not get it, but I do love it, and I wanted to mention it anyway. Next is Andy Candy. Their new Cupcake Cat eyeshadow palette. It is available now. It retails for $40. It features a mixture of shimmer, satin, and matte tones, cruelty-free and vegan. I think it's cute. I think it's expensive, but again, that is me. But I do think it is really, really cute, you know. This is, yeah, I like this. This is cute. So yeah, let me know if you have tried anything from Andy Candy and if it is worth the price. I know it's an indie brand and I know the price of indie brands can be a little bit higher. But still, yeah, I like this. I think it's cute. Yeah, now we are coming to something that is a bit, yeah. It is very expensive to create eyeshadows, so a lot of companies use kind of pre-made eyeshadows and then sell it under their own name, and that's called private labeling. A lot of the times that goes okay, but sometimes, yeah. So I have here 3 brands that are releasing the same eyeshadow palette, basically. I will put the pictures up. So we have Luscious Luxe, we have Bellegant, and we have Alluring Cosmetics. And I will let you be the judge of it. For me, they look the same. So, yeah, that's a bit of a boo-boo, isn't it? They are not ripping each other off. It's just private labeling, and I get it. You know, as I said, it is very expensive for brands to make their own eyeshadow, and a lot of brands use private labeling. I'm not hating it. I mentioned it last week. I still think it is a really cute palette. So if you want it, you know, just see where it's sold the cheapest. That's basically it, I think. The last thing that I have is from Alien Cosmetics, because they are saying here, after popular demand, pre-order is now open for their Pluto palette. So they are bringing it back. Estimated launch date, the 1st of June. Get it for the discounted price of $25. The date of the launch, it will go up to $30. I think it's really, really pretty. I think it's nice and summery, and yeah. Let me know how you feel about it. And that was it. That was it for my Let's Talk Makeup number 36. It was a lot, I feel. I feel like I have been speeding through it like, I don't know, a fast runaway train or something along those lines. I don't know. But yeah, let me know down below if you know any of the brands, if you are planning on picking anything up. I am not planning on picking anything up from this week's collections, I think. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to, kind of enjoy the weather. I know. I'm going to walk with my dog because I want to go outside. I want to go to the dike. I want to stare at the ocean and, just the way. let me think how I can translate it. It's not blowing out, winding out. I don't know. It's something that we say, at least in my family, uitwaaien. And that literally means outblowing, you know, just, I don't know, standing on the dike here, staring at the ocean, letting the wind blow out all the cobwebs in your ears and all that goodness, you know, let the wind kind of cleanse you. That is basically what it means. I just don't know how to translate it because some things are just not really translatable, are they? Doesn't lay us any Windex. If you're Dutch, you'll probably get it. I am going to stop talking. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one, which will be, if I'm not mistaken, tomorrow. So yeah, that's it. Yeah, bye guys.